Hey everyone, this is Anurag Ray from ConsumerWarrior.com, and in this video I'm going to talk about can bed bugs live in your hair. Now before we continue this video, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and click the notification bell so that you can receive updates about my video and also help my channel grow. Now bed bugs usually lives on the bed, as the name suggests. They usually hide under the beds and then comes out in the middle of the night while you are sleeping and then suck your blood. But if the infestation is really high in your house and if you're not doing anything about that, then the bed bugs can actually come closer to you, and while they're drinking your blood, they can also get on your hair. But as you know, hair can be quite messy, it can be thick, and if the bed bugs get over there, and it won't be able to come out from that place easily. And because of that reason, there can be, if the infestation is really high, there can be a lot of bed bugs getting caught on your hair. Not intentionally though, but they can get caught on your hair. Now it can also happen that the bed bugs has went there not to get stuck by the hair but to suck blood from your head. So it is also possible the bed bugs can go over there. If the infestation is really high, then the bed bugs can go over there and try to suck blood, and as a result in the process the bed bugs can get caught on your hair. Now if that happens, you should immediately take actions to get rid of these unwanted bed bugs from your hair, and do some shampoo, use some proper chemicals to get rid of these unwanted bugs, because you don't really want them on your hair because they can be dangerous. In those situations, better to not use your hand to get rid of these bed bugs, because thing can also get on your head and it won't be coming out. Not force that, and if you feel like the bed bug hasn't come out even after removing it, then you should definitely visit a doctor to get rid of this unwanted bed bugs. This is a serious condition, and if the infestation is really high, this is not something really optimal for your house and not for yourself, because they can suck your blood, and if the infestation is increasing and it's really high, and they can do some serious damage to you also, because they will suck in so much blood that you may also feel anemic after certain time. And you probably won't be able to identify what caused this, because in most cases, people actually forget that those are bed bugs. That people think that those have occurred because of allergies. Now, allergy has nothing to do with over here, because these are bed bugs, and there are some similarities, like they're itching and there will be soreness over there, and the spot will turn red. It feels like there has been some allergies, and some people also might suspect that there's some kind of bug has bitten them, but very few people actually are able to tell that these are because of bed bugs. So the first and foremost thing to stop this from occurring is you have to get rid of the unwanted bed bugs from your house, and for doing so you have to use a lot of different kind of things to get rid of them. The one of the ways, definitely you can use pesticides. Different kind of insecticides are also out there that can actually get rid of the bed bugs, specifically designed for the bed bugs. Along with that, you can also use diatomaceous earth to get rid of the unwanted bed bugs from your house, because those bed bugs are also really not good for because the diatomaceous earth is really easy to use, and you can find it online for different kind of places, and you can use them to get rid of the unwanted bed bugs, because these bed bugs are actually not really good for you, and removing them is one of your first priority. So even if the remedies that you find online are quite expensive, you should do and get the best remedies to keep yourself safe, because bed bugs can do a lot of damage if you have a children on your house, and if you are living with your family, because they will suck blood from every single one who is sleeping on that bed. And of course, in some situation, the bed bugs can also be identified, because if the infestation is high and they are starting to come out in the middle of the night while you are sleeping, you will feel pain while they are actually biting you, and because of that you can actually get you can wake up and you can identify that there are bed bugs. And if that happens, you can also use the pesticide, insecticide by yourself, or you can call your pest control company to actually get rid of the unwanted bed bugs from your house. They can charge you different kind of money depending upon the infestation, but they are really good at their work and can actually get rid of the unwanted bed bugs from your house, which is really important. Now, another important factor is that you need to know why this bed bugs infestation starts and how to stop it from happening in the first place. In many cases, it has been found that bed bugs doesn't always come inside the house. It actually are brought from somewhere else. They doesn't come inside the house automatically. They are actually brought from somewhere else. Now, for example, if you have been to some places and there was any bed bugs in that place, you didn't see them, you don't really need a big number to start the infestation. Maybe there are a few, one or two, or maybe three or four bed bugs in a particular place, and they got inside on your luggage. And while you are coming back from that place, you sit and come inside your house, and you don't realize that there are bed bugs inside your luggage. And while unpacking, or for some reason, those bed bugs comes out, and you don't see them. Of course, in most cases you won't even see them. They will get inside in some of the places, and not just in the beds, it can sit on other places also, and start growing their population. And before you realize that, their population will increase so fast that you will feel the bed bug has come inside your house and they have started growing, but actually it was you who bought it. So every single time you go outside, make sure to check that place properly and check your luggage after you come back home, so that this kind of situation doesn't occur. Because this is something, if the infestation starts, it can be quite difficult to get rid of, because bed bugs are quite tough to kill, even for the most pest control company. Although they does the job quite really well, but it's tough for even for the pest control company. So that gives you a clear idea how difficult it could be to actually get rid of these bed bugs. So make sure to stop them beforehand, and make sure to just be careful. Just to be, if you are careful, that will be more than enough to actually get rid of this unwanted bed bugs. So just be careful and you will be safe. And when you come inside your home, make sure to check it. That's all you need to do. You don't really have to do any kind of serious things. Don't really need to use any insecticide or pesticides on your cloths on your luggage. Just take them out. Just if any cloth has this kind of bed bugs, you will probably be able to see immediately after unpacking. If you're not able to see it, then definitely the chances are that there are no bed bugs. And another important factor over here is, if you feel like there are allergies going on in your body and you feel like something is biting in the middle of the night, even if you cannot see them, you should consider that it can be a bed bug. So in that case, you should look around inside your bed and check that if there is any bed bug over there or not. And doing so will also stop the infestation from happening in the first place, and can save a lot of trouble and can save a lot of money. So make sure to do that. And if you find the bed bugs, definitely use some of the remedies. And in the early stages, it will be not that difficult. You can just throw them out also and catch them and just throw them out. But in the later on, if the infestation grows, it can be really difficult. So do it early on, check yourself, check everything over there, and you will be good to go. So that's it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to click on the like, comment, and subscribe button. I'm uploading 2 videos every single week, that is on Monday and Friday. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button and click the notification bell, so you're going to see updates about my videos. Thank you.